Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I want to make one more video if I had the energy and the time to do it. God bless you guys. The Lord had given me several messages. I want to do one more here tonight. Matthew 15, starting in verse 32, says, "Then Jesus called his disciples and said unto them, and he said, I have compassion on the multitude because they continue with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I will not send them away fasting, lest they faint in the way. And his disciples said unto him, Whence should we have so much bread in the wilderness as to fill so great a multitude? And Jesus said unto them, How many loaves have ye? And they said, 7 and a few fish. And he commanded the multitudes to sit down on the ground, took the 7 loaves and the fish, and gave thanks, and brake them, and gave to his disciples, and his disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat, and were filled. And they took up the broken meat that was left, 7 baskets full, and they did eat of 4,000 men, besides women and children. And he sent away the multitude and took ship and came into the coast of Magdala." Now, I'm going to say something about this text that I've never heard before, and I don't know if any of you guys ever heard it before. Probably not. The Lord just dropped this on me. And we talk about, you know, multiplication and all those kind of things. This is what the Lord told me, you know, was quickening in my spirit. Is that, you know, God will provide for you. Just like Mary and Martha, you know, one of them was busy running around cooking and the other one was there sitting at his feet, and the other sister, you know, was mad. Martha was mad because Mary was there listening to Jesus instead of helping her cook and clean the house. And Jesus said, you know, she's chosen the better thing to do. You know, don't take that away from her. You know, you're fretting with the service of the ministry, and then Mary just wants to spend time with me. These people were the same thing. This is something, you know, I never looked at it this way, but the Lord just dropped it on me. This is for you and me, brothers and sisters. Jesus said, I have compassion on the multitude because they've continued with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat, and I will not send them away fasting, and they faint in the night. If you stay with Jesus, he'll provide for you. If you follow Jesus, he will provide for you. That's a message from the Lord. He will provide for you. He is Jehovah Jireh. That's the word of the Lord to you today. Take up your cross daily, he says in Luke. Take up he who does not take up his cross daily. Daily, it says in Luke. And follow me is not worthy of me. He who does not take up his cross daily and follow me is not worthy of me. Every day, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. Hey, follow Jesus and he will provide for you. He will provide for you, brothers and sisters, all the things that you need. You know, when I first got called into the ministry and I was working full time, of course, my relatives are greasy gracers. They went to the altar when they were 10 years old. And now, you know, they've been living like the devil all their lives, you know, and they think they're Christians, but they're pro-abortion, pro-gay marriage, all that stuff. You know, you guys have relatives like that too. As soon as I got called to the ministry, the first thing I heard from my backslid relatives, don't quit your job. Don't think God's going to, you know, provide for you. You got to keep working and all this. And, you know, and discouragement, discouragement, discouragement. Get off this Jesus kick. You got to get off this Jesus kick. You know, you need to live in the real world. You know, you need to be out here in the real world. You need to stop, you know, thinking about God and start thinking about this world. That's what, can you imagine? You know, that's why, it came up in my spirit from the Lord. But the Bible says to honor your mother and father. But it came up in my spirit from the Holy Spirit to say, get behind me, Satan. But, by the grace of God, you know, I did not say that, even though I should have when those things were said unto me. But brothers and sisters, that's when I was new. But you know what? God had better plans for me, not to be turned back, not to be discouraged. You know, that I'm going on. There's a gospel hymnal song. It's called I'm Going On Until the Final Triumph. I'm going on. I'm going on, I'm going on, until the final triumph. I'm going on, I'm going on, I'm going on, until the final triumph. I'm going on. I don't remember all of the different verses of it. Brothers and sisters, if I remember, I'll put a link below this video. But praise God, brothers and sisters, we have to keep going on. We have to keep pressing on and following Jesus. He will provide. He's not going to send us away hungry. He's going to feed us. Now, I know we talk about, you know, the Lord feeds us our daily bread and the Word and all that. And that's true. People would use this text to say that. I'm saying the Lord will provide you all things, as it says in the Bible. May God provide you, you know, all things through His riches in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. As it says in, 3 John, may you prosper and be in good health even as your soul prospers. God will prosper you in the way. Hallelujah. If you walk in the way of Jesus, hallelujah, not in the, you know, turning to the right or to the left, but walking in the way of Jesus, God will provide for you. He will provide what you need, brothers and sisters. He will open doors that no man can shut and shut doors that no man can open. He will open the doors that you need to have that job. You know, you can have that job where you can serve Him and get paid to work in the world. God owns it all. The Bible says He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills and the gold thereof, all the world and the fullness thereof. The world is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the Bible says. He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. God owns it all, brothers and sisters. The Bible also says that the wealth of the wicked is stored up for the righteous. Hallelujah. Don't worry about tomorrow, Jesus said, for tomorrow will take care of itself. God will provide. And that's the greatest Bible verse right now. The Lord is reminding me that I wasn't even thinking about. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. The greatest Bible verse for everyone who's already born again to know. Jesus said, Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. And all those earthly things you're worried about will be given unto you. When Jesus is talking right before that, He says, you know what? Who by worrying could add 1 inch to your height? Or change the hair on your head from gray to dark or whatever? No, you can't do it. Jesus said, see the lilies of the valley? You know, they don't do any work, but yet they're clothed finer than King Solomon was. You know, and Jesus said, if God can provide for them, He can provide for you, O ye of little faith. Matthew chapter 6, in verse 33, He says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God. Follow Jesus first. I'm not talking about say a sinner's prayer. I'm not talking about just saying a sinner's prayer. I'm talking about following Jesus. Jesus said, take up your cross daily and follow Me. He didn't say a prayer and then go your own way. No, I am the way, He said. Follow Me. That's what He told His disciples. Follow Me and I'll make you fishers of men. Follow Me, Jesus said. So follow Him. He'll feed you spiritual bread and natural bread. The Lord will provide fish for you. He will give you wells that you didn't dig, houses you didn't build, vineyards you didn't plant. Will He give into the bosom of His people? The blessings of the law we have. The Bible says we've been redeemed from the curse of the law, but not the blessings. I'm quoting from the blessings of the law. You'll be the head and not the tail. You'll be the first and not the last. You'll be blessed in the city and blessed in the country, blessed going in and blessed going out. You have wells you didn't dig, vineyards you didn't plant, houses you didn't build. If you will follow the Lord, Jesus Christ, in the way, the narrow way, hallelujah. He'll provide for you if you follow Him. Jesus, check this out. Jesus fed the 4,000 men plus women and children that were with Him. He didn't feed people that were somewhere else. He fed those that were with Him. He multiplied what they had. You know, you may only have $100 in your bank. God multiplied that. Provide for you to pay your bills and get a better job and get a raise and give you favor with you. You can have a wicked boss. I mean, oh, my boss is an atheist. God can bless you, and as He says in His Word, I will prepare a table for you in the presence of your enemies. Hallelujah. God prepares a table for us in the presence of our enemies. Hallelujah. He's going to bless you. The more people persecute you, the more He blesses you, brothers and sisters. That's just like in my situation. The more I'm treated as a black sheep of the family, because I'm a servant of God, the more God's going to keep blessing me and blessing me and blessing me. So, you know, the Lord even told me that one time. You know, welcome persecution from the world. Because when you walk in with me, I'm going to bless you more and more and more. I'm going to show my love for my people. I'm going to show that they are salt and light. I'm going to show that they're blessed and highly favored. I'm going to put, just like in the land of Goshen, I'm going to put a rift. I'm going to put a distance between you and the devil's people. I'm going to make you shine so that the devil's people will see it and be provoked to repentance, to provoke to jealousy. They'll say, hey, something's going on here. There's something different. Why is this person who I hate, that's a loser, that's a follower of Jesus, why are they blessed? And why am I cursed? Why am I in a pit? Why are they on top of the palace? Why is that? Why is that? What's going on? I tell you what's going on. Jesus provides. He is Jehovah Jireh. He provides for his people. He blesses his people. He feeds those that are with him. All those backsliders, that's a message for a backslider. You go up there and tell your backslider friends, that's the word of the Lord God Most High in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Go tell those backsliding people that you know, Jesus fed the multitudes that were with him. He gave bread and fish to those who followed him for 3 days, those who were with him, who listened to his preaching and walked with him in the way that he was walking. But all those people that were supposed to be saying, oh, I believe Jesus is the Messiah, but they weren't following him. They were off on their own way, doing their own thing. They didn't get any fish and bread. They were out there struggling, wallowing around in the mud and clowning around trying to get something to eat. And here is those people who are walking with Jesus getting spiritual food, hearing the sermons of the Lord, the teachings of the Lord, the wisdom of the Lord. The Lord was praying for them. They were being healed. The multitudes were being healed of palsy and blindness and deafness and all these different things. And even on top of that, the Lord physically, literally fed them food. He blessed them in every way, spiritually and naturally. You know, lots of people, that's the thing about these old denominational people. They love to talk about, okay, a spiritual blessing. Oh, I got saved. I know I got saved. Jesus didn't only save people. He physically healed people. He physically blessed people, food, financial, all those things. The Lord blessed people in every way, in our spirit and our natural man, in all things. It reminds me of a text. And I don't know exactly where it is right now, but Peter was saying to the Lord, you know, we've given up everything for you. What about us? We've given up everything for you, Lord. And the Lord said, you will have, mansions and all these things in this life and in the life to come with persecution, with persecution. And people love to quote that part where it says with persecution. But he said, you will have mansions and all those things in this life and in the life to come. You'll have blessings in heaven and God will bless you on earth too. But you'll have persecution. And you know what? That is the reason why lots of people are not walking with Jesus. Many of you maybe that are watching this video, you're not walking with Jesus because you've been persecuted. Someone insulted you. Somebody said something to you. Your own relatives dragging you down, pulling you down. God rewards those who don't let the devil's children and his terrors pull you down. Now, you know that's the big problem in the Philippines. It's a communal country. It's not an individualistic country like the Western culture. It's a communal culture. I've been to the Philippines, prayed with people. They got saved. Then they went back to their relatives. Their relatives are ready to disown them, kick them out in the street. You know, because they all live in the same house most of the time. So they're ready to throw them out in the street and make them sleep outside if they don't, deny the faith. And of course, 99% of the time, they deny the faith. Their family is their God. They put their family above the Lord. They deny the Lord. They act like they don't even know who you are. I've seen it thousands of times in the Philippines. There's lots of Americans doing the same thing. They'd rather please people, please their relatives, please their friends, and that ain't even really persecution. That's what they want to call persecution. That ain't persecution really anyway. It's not persecution like being fed to the lions in Rome, getting your head chopped off for not taking the mark during the tribulation, something like that. Now that's persecution. What the church in Saudi Arabia faces, in China, the underground church, all these countries. Now they have persecution. American church ain't seen no persecution yet, brothers and sisters. We don't know what's persecution in the United States because your friends won't hang out with you. Why you want to go hang out with them? You're supposed to be following Jesus with the other followers of Jesus, working with the followers of Jesus. That's your family. What did Jesus say when they said, oh, your mother and your brothers and your sister, your mother and your brothers and sisters are here to see you? Jesus said, who is my mother? Who are my brothers? But those who hear my words and keep them, they are my mother and those are my brothers and sisters. So we are a family. Those of you who are in Christ. We are brothers and sisters. If we're born again Christians, more than anybody in this world, we are family, brothers and sisters. And we have one Father who is in heaven. You know, and parents and fathers always don't like it when the children are fighting. And that's a big problem. I'm not talking about the world now. I'm not talking about ecumenicalism with Chrislam and all that. I'm talking about born again Christians. People who are really children of God. We are all one in Christ as born again Christians. Like I say again, I'll disclaimer, of course, I'm not talking about cults, Mormons, Jehovah's Witnesses, all this kind of cults, churches that are not born again. Any person that's not born again is not a Christian. You have to be born again to be a Christian. You know, it doesn't mean what denomination you go to, but you must be born again, Jesus said. John 3:3. If a man enter the kingdom of heaven, he must be born again. Born from above. Born by the Spirit of God. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. I did this bit led by the Lord. I made a little preaching there. Just a little bit of preaching. So, God bless you guys. I even did a little bit of singing. The Lord just dropped all these great messages on me today. I was kind of tired out, but I wanted to get these videos made anyway. So hopefully my tiredness didn't limit the messages that the Lord gave me. God bless you guys. I love you guys. Still got some oil left. Anybody want any oil or a book and oil or the book? And I'm starting to work on the new book. I ask for your prayers about the book as I'm starting on it now. God bless you guys. I hope all of you guys, this is also the beginning of the new year in the world. I hope this is a great opportunity to start reading your Bible. Like I say, I'll caution you again and discuss it with you again. Unless you've been a Christian for a long time and reading your Bible, I would advise you to read the New Testament. If you're new or you never read the Bible, read the New Testament. You don't have to sit there and read all the Gospels back to back. You can read, I just want to tell you the fastest thing to do, so you can get through the Bible. Read Matthew and then read John or Luke and John. You can read Luke and John or Matthew and John and then read all the letters. Read all the letters. You don't necessarily have to read Revelation right now. You can read it. But when you start reading Revelation, you have to really know the whole Bible to read Revelation, really, after Revelation chapter 4. Anybody, you can read anything you want. But as far as understanding goes, brothers and sisters, the book of Revelation, of course, I don't believe the Lord lets us understand it but so much. Because, He's keeping it sealed. You know, He's keeping it hidden until the right time. During those times, people will understand it. But we can have general understandings of it. Not all this specific, people trying to decipher all these details. It's not been given to us to know that. So anyway, you can read Revelation, but there's lots of people who've never read the Bible, and then the first thing they do is open it up. I got a crazy alcoholic relative who's an agnostic, and he loves to whip open Revelation and start reading and all liquored up and crazy and talking wacky stuff. I mean, the book of Revelation is for people that you got to really know the whole Bible, because it draws on the Old Testament, especially Daniel and all this. And, you really have to have really a really good understanding of the whole Bible to understand Revelation. And then it's still, God has got it sealed. It's still sealed up. And there's always that person that comes along that got saved yesterday, and then they suddenly believe they're Elijah. They're some special prophet, and then they God has given them. They have all the answers. And then they'll make a video, and then people will believe it. And what are you going to do, brothers and sisters? Hey, it's time to stop running to and fro. It's time to be serious and grow up in the Lord and be mature in the Lord. And by the grace of God, let the year 2015 be a year of maturity and growth in discipleship in the kingdom of God, that we're going to be closer. Let's become more prepared to meet the Lord in the air, brothers and sisters. Let's be prepared to be that bride, the wise virgins, the bride without spot or blemish. Let's move in that direction. Let's get there. Let's get there. And how do we get there? By following Jesus. Circling around Jesus and go where He goes. Where the Lord wants us to go, let's go. Let's go in the way of Jesus, not in our own paths. Let's follow Jesus, brothers and sisters. God bless you.